You probably heard the theory that we're all living in a simulation, specifically an ancestor simulation. This isn't a fringe conspiracy theory, but an idea that has been touted by Elon Musk, Neil deGrasse Tyson, and other very intelligent people. And in this quick video, I'm going to be going over the initial philosophical argument for this idea called the simulation hypothesis put forth by Nick Bostrom, and examine if there are any logical grounds to believe we are really living in a simulation. And if you like this video at any point and think it's interesting or helpful, please give it a thumbs up, as this really helps its visibility in the YouTube algorithm. And also make sure to subscribe for more videos like it below. Okay, first let's take a look at the original simulation hypothesis by Bostrom, and then we'll dive into why it may not be true. So Bostrom proposed a trilemma argument in his paper, Are You Living in a Computer Simulation?, in which he didn't outright state that we're living in a simulation, just that one of the following statements is most likely true. Number one, the fraction of all human-level civilizations that reach a post-human stage, that is, one capable of running high-fidelity ancestor simulations, is very close to zero. Or number two, the fraction of post-human civilizations that are interested in running simulations of their evolutionary history or variations thereof is very close to zero. Or number three, the fraction of all people with our kind of experiences that are living in a simulation is very close to one. Here's what that means. Because we believe we can develop very advanced computing power in the future that could run lifelike simulations, we can conceive that it is most likely that an even more advanced civilization has already developed it if we live in a multiverse full of different universes, as many physicists believe. Suppose some of these advanced civilizations were to run what he calls ancestor simulations with this advanced technology, or simulations of ancestral life that would be indistinguishable from reality to the simulated ancestor. In that case, the total number of simulated ancestors, dubbed sims, will far exceed the actual real-life ancestors. A typical observer is likely to be in one of the simulations, rather than a member of the top civilization producing the ancestor simulations. So we should assume that we are typical within the set of all such observers in this simulated multiverse. In other words, if there was a civilization that made it to the stage where they can run advanced lifelike simulations and chose to do so, which it seems plausible that could happen, that means that we're most likely in a simulation since there would be far more sims than real people. If we're not in a simulation, then according to Bostrom, all or most civilizations died out before they could run advanced ancestor simulations, or they just never felt like doing so. One of these very unlikely three scenarios is most likely correct, and it's probably number three, we're in a simulation. In his paper, Bostrom outlines that this isn't your typical highly skeptical argument, like the René Descartes evil demon that tricks our senses, but this is a serious metaphysical hypothesis in which we have real grounds to consider. We have useful data that highly suggests that lifelike ancestor simulations can be run and will be run in our not-too-distant future. Just take a look at how lifelike video games are now compared to just a few years ago. Now imagine what they're going to look like in 20 years or 100 years from now. It seems plausible that virtual reality and simulations will be indistinguishable from reality, right? But wouldn't we know we're in a simulation, and wouldn't sims be unconscious? We have consciousness, so we must be the real civilization, right? Bostrom details that if we are able to model the mind closely enough, artificial minds will work exactly the same way as regular minds do, including giving rise to conscious experience. He believes in a physicalist interpretation of what consciousness is. Plus, if we were to simulate the entire universe in detail and feed it into the artificial mind, it would have no way of knowing it was in a simulation. Life or it would be exactly like it is now. That is the argument in a nutshell. Now, I'll link to the full paper by him below so you could, if you want to explore it in more detail. So are we living in a simulation? I think we're not, and there's at least more reasons to think that we're not than we are right now. And here's why. One objection to the simulation theory comes from Paul Davies, a physicist who uses reductio ad absurdum to argue that the idea is self-defeating. He says Bostrom's argument presupposes that we're living in a near-infinite multiverse, allowing a universe to contain advanced post-human level civilization that could reach the stage to choose to run advanced simulations. However, if there's infinite multiverses and then infinite simulated multiverses, Bostrom's argument becomes self-defeating and he needs to rewrite it or abandon it. We can't have infinite multiverses that are real plus near-infinite simulated multiverses in the argument for it to even work. An even better argument against the simulation theory is questioning if we're really typical observers. This seems like a sort of fake humility that we actually have no grounds to accept, as there could be many types of different simulations and simulated civilizations. If near-infinite simulations were run, we can probably conclude that using Bostrom's logic, The most of these simulations won't have the ability to run simulations themselves, or even can be able to conceive of a simulation. Yet the argument states that it's easy to conceive of creating high-fidelity ancestor simulations. Now, using his own logic, if we're to be typical observers, we should have no idea what a simulation really is. Yet we're here and can conceive of running advanced simulations, which is what I'm thinking about right now in this video, which means that his argument doesn't hold. And finally, there's no actual empirical evidence that shows we are in a simulation. Our best known theory of energy and matter shows how our universe could have been created without the need for a simulator or intelligent creator. And scientific experiments designed to look for evidence that we're in a simulation have yet to turn up anything. Yes, perhaps the simulators were so intelligent that they made sure to carefully hide the evidence, but using Bayesian reasoning, isn't the better theory just to accept that we're in the real world as of now than a simulation that's purely hypothetical to this point? Now, overall, I actually like the simulation argument because it shakes up our notions of what ontology is and what we may consider to be natural laws in reality, even though I think it's flawed. And I do agree with him that this is a class separate than the highly skeptical René Descartes type argument. And I'll be looking forward to reading any future papers or books by Mr. Bostrom. So let me know what you think. If you like this video or not, and you think it's helpful or interesting, please consider giving it a thumbs up again and subscribing below using the link in the description for more videos like it. So thanks for watching, and let me know what you think of the simulation argument below.